Beijing has dared to submit its South China Sea claims to international arbitration. The Philippine Defense Chief issued a challenge in response to China's latest attacks on Philippine resupply boats. Katrina Domingo has tonight's top story.
Philippine Defense Secretary Gilbert Teodoro dares Beijing to bring before international arbitration its maritime claims in the West Philippine Sea. Chinese vessels again attacked the latest resupply mission of the Philippines to Ayungin Shoal over the weekend. A resupply vessel was damaged. Three Filipinos were hurt.
Hindi tayo ang humaharang ng kahit sino man sa West Philippine Sea. Tayo ang hinaharang. So anong gagawin natin? Titihaya na lang? Hindi naman siguro pwede. Kung talagang gusto nila, kung talaga siguro hindi sila natatakot na ihayag sa buong mundo ang kanilang claim, bakit hindi tayo magpa-arbitrate sa ilalim ng international law para maliwanag sa lahat kung ano ang karapatan ng kahit sino? Bakit ayaw nila?
Teodoro adds China is the only nation believing its own propaganda that it has rights over nearly the entire South China Sea, a strategic maritime route where trillions worth of seaborne goods pass through annually.
Alam na naman ang buong mundo na illegal ang ginagawa ng China na pagkukupkop ng West Philippine Sea batay sa kanilang hindi kapanipaniwalang historical narrative na walang bansa sa buong mundo na naniniwala at maraming bumabatikos. Kami ay hindi magpapasubo ng ating mga kababayan sa panganib. Ngunit ang panganib ay lumalapit sa atin. So anong gagawin natin? Hindi naman tayo nambubuyo dito eh. Ano bang pagbubuyo ang ginawa natin? Kung ginawa natin ito within their 200 nautical mile exclusive economic zone sa may Hainan Island, yun ang provokasyon. Eh dito nila ginagawa eh.
The Department of Foreign Affairs summoned Chinese Embassy in Manila's Chargé d'Affaires, Zhao Xingyong, to lodge protests against China's continued aggressions in Philippine waters. In a statement, the DFA says that DFA Undersecretary Teresa Lazaro and Chinese Vice Foreign Minister Shen Xiaodong have spoken over the phone about the incident. While the Philippine Embassy in Beijing has lodged a demarche before China's Ministry of Foreign Affairs to demand all Chinese vessels to leave the Philippines' exclusive economic zone, underscoring that Beijing's interference in Manila's resupply missions in the West Philippine Sea is unacceptable. The agency adds that China's actions in the West Philippine Sea undermines the Philippines' sincere efforts to implement the instruction of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. and Chinese President Xi Jinping to de-escalate tensions in the region. Manila also reminds Beijing that several nations, including the U.S., Canada, Australia, New Zealand, Japan, South Korea, France, Germany, and Sweden, are all backing the Philippine stance that China should abide by international laws and respect the rights of other countries guaranteed under the United Nations Convention on the Law of the Sea, or UNCLOS. Some Philippine senators also lambasted China for attacking a civilian vessel. Senator Gray Spoh calls China's actions uncivilized and emphasized that Asia's largest economy should be held responsible for the incident, especially after Filipinos were hurt. Senator Francis Tolentino urges the DFA to forge maritime research and development partnerships with countries that have yet to sign defense agreements with the Philippines. In the House of Representatives, House Bill 1015, which seeks to create the Philippine Coast Guard Modernization Act Trust Fund, has been filed to further boost the capabilities of the PCG. Under the proposal, 40% of the annual oil pollution management fund and other penalties collected by the PCG should be allocated to the trust fund to ensure that they will have sufficient budget for modernization. Authors of the bill note that a decade and a half since the Philippine Coast Guard law was passed in 2009, the PCG now has a bigger role to play and therefore is in need of more resources. President Marcos Jr. is scheduled to travel to the United States next month to participate in a trilateral summit with the U.S. and Japan, a meeting which is expected to boost the three countries' efforts to keep the Indo-Pacific open and free. Katrina Domingo, ABS-CBN News.